Ella goes, and then you go. You go after Ella.
I go after Ella.
That's all you got.
After I read the epistle, the part that I'm reading, I'd also like to share a line from a poem that I...
Yes, that's great. Okay. I'd love you to do that. Yeah. Okay. And watch this. I can't
hear you unless you look right at me and get in my ear.
This is our camera right here. Watch the camera.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, but yes.
So don't put my head over it.
Thank you. Pentecost. Our service begins on page 4 of your bulletin or 355 of your Book of Common Prayer. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Charge over you, stone. You shall tread upon the lion and outback. You shall trample the young lion and the serpent under your feet.
Because it is bound to me in love, therefore I will deliver him. I will protect him because he knows my name.
He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I am with him in trouble. I will rescue him and bring him to honor.
With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation.
Every high priest chosen from among mortals is put in charge of things pertaining to God on their behalf to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins. He is able to deal gently with the ignorant and wayward, since he himself is subject to weakness. And because of this, he must offer sacrifice for his own sins as well as for those of the people. And one does not presume to take this honor, but takes it only when called by God, just as Aaron was. So also Christ did not glorify himself in becoming a high priest, but was appointed by the one who said to him, "You are my son. Today I have begotten you." And he says also in another place, "You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek." In the days of his flesh, Jesus offered up prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears to the one who was able to save him from death. And he was heard because of his reverence and mission. Although he was a son, he learned obedience through what he suffered. And having been made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation for all those who obey him. Having been designated by God, a high priest according to the order of Melchizedek. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I'd also like to offer a line from a poem that I read many years ago called The Desiderata, written in 1933 by a fellow named Max Herrmann. The line goes, "You are a child of the universe, no less than the trees and the stars. You have a right to be here. Therefore, be at peace with God." All the proof that I need of the reality of God is sitting out here in this room in our baby girl. Amen.
You know that among the Gentiles, those whom they recognize
as their rulers lord it over them, and their great ones are tyrants over them. But it is not so among you. But whoever wishes to become great among you must be your servant, and whoever wishes to be first among you must be slave of all. For the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
And that's what baptism is. It's a covenant.
it's not a one-sided covenant. It's not a job well done, you get a certificate, and you're on your way. It's an invitation. A deeper relationship with the one who gives us life. And this invitation is open to us all, whether you're a newborn or nearing the end of life. And we typically do it when they're a young child, even at times when we don't understand that relationship, because they are God. They are God's children, beautiful children. And no matter what your age or background, God's message is the same. You are my beloved, and with you I am well pleased. And at its core, baptism is God's pure, grace-filled, unconditional love in action. It's not just an invitation to church. It's a drawing of the light of Christ, where we become his light in the shining in the world. That's why I've been so started clean. But when Jesus emerged from the waters of the Jordan, a voice came from heaven and declared, "This is my son, the beloved, with whom I am well pleased." And before Jesus began his ministry, God was already well pleased. Before he faced the wilderness, healed the sick, cast out demons, preached the good news, and died on the cross for us, God was already well pleased. And soon after, Jesus ministered to the least and the lost and the lame and the little ones. He shared God's unconditional love with everyone. The same love Jesus shows to each of us. A love that doesn't deepen on what we do or who simply we are in him. As Christians, Jesus is our example. He wasn't baptized in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. He was baptized along with many other sinners for repentance. A symbolic reminder that we are forgiven forever of our sins because of the work Christ did and for what he did for us on the cross. Did Jesus need to repent? No. But through baptism, he showed us the way, the example. And as a church family, we share the excitement of the parents and God's parents, and we're reminded of how God's grace works in our lives and the miracles he performs every day, just like the miracle in Lachlan. One of the ways God celebrates and confirms his love by us is extending special gifts, and one of those is the gift of baptism. Through the work of God's Spirit in baptism, we are made alive again. Through the work of his Son, we gain eternal life, and we serve a loving and gracious God who, in his mercy, has done everything for us and for our salvation. Now, at Lachlan's baptism today, you might not hear this voice coming from heaven, "You are my beloved, with you I am well pleased." But that's exactly how God feels about us. And each and every one of us that are here to witness this event. So when you think of Lachlan's baptism, my prayer is that you don't think about soap. That we reflect on the miracle that took place here today. The miracle that washed away sin and made her alive in Christ. And as a reminder to us that God loves us, as witnesses, it is all of our duties to show her the way to a good Christian life. May the Spirit keep us all in steadfast faith, that we may continually rejoice in the miracle of our baptism. Today, the Lord is well pleased with us all, and especially welcome. Amen. Alleluia.
Hallelujah.
The candidate for holy baptism will now be presented. Will you be responsible for seeing that the child you present is brought up in the Christian faith and life? Will you, by your prayers and witness, help this child to grow into the full stature of Christ?
And will live with God's help.
Do you renounce Satan and all the spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the evil powers of this world which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God?
I renounce that.
Do you renounce all sinful desires to draw you from the love of God?
I renounce that.
Do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept him as your Savior?
I do.
Do you put your whole trust in the grace, in his grace and love?
I do.
Do you promise to follow and obey him as your Lord?
I do.
This is to the congregation. Would you respond with will you, who witness these vows, do all in your power to support Lachlan and her life in Christ?
We will.
Let's join together with Lachlan, who's committing herself to Christ, and renew our own baptismal covenant. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord.
Born of the Virgin Mary, he suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, in the Lord, the Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of the bread, and in the prayers?
I will, with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fail into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will, with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, with God's help.
Let us now pray for Lachlan, who will receive the sacrament of new birth.
Deliver her, O Lord, from the way of sin and death.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Open her heart to your grace and truth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill her with your holy and life-giving spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Keep her in the faith and communion of your holy church.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach her to love others in the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Send her into the world and witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring her to the fullness of your peace and glory.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Grant, O Lord, that all who are baptized in the death of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of his resurrection and look for him to come in glory, who lives and reigns with you and now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over it, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through it, you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt into the land of promise. In it, your son Jesus received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through his death and resurrection from the bondage of sin into everlasting life. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it, we are buried with Christ in his death, but we share in his resurrection. Through it, we were reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we bring into the fellowship those who come to him in faith, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Sanctify this water, we pray you, by the power of the Holy Spirit, that those who are cleansed from sin and born again may continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory, now and forever.
Amen.
Shine his light into the world, so will Rocklin shine her light. Turn over to the other page and say a prayer as we're walking. I present to you the newest person of our Christian community, St. Mary the Virgin, and our Christian family, Lachlan Rebecca Blair. congratulations. Great job.
Hey, do you believe in Jesus Christ?
What?
Yes.
Yes.
No announcements other than the family has invited you to reception in the parish hall after the service, so feel free to partake in all the goodies that they have prepared over there. They decorated it beautifully, and we're forever grateful for your family and the spirit you share with St. Mary's, so thank you. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself to us in offering and sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
of Israel to be your people, in your words spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be a incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil, and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, and out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember
his death. We proclaim his resurrection. We await his coming in glory.
And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from creation this bread and this wine. We pray, you gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they will be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit in the fullness of time, and put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to the heavenly country, where with Saint Mary and all your saints, we may enter into the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
"Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us all trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, Lord, forever and ever. Amen."
Alleluia. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
Thank you.
The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and grant you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.